Hi there, this is Mr. Weyberg. We're looking today at adding integers. And we want to look at three different methods of adding integers. First, using a number line. Second, using zero pairs. And finally, using rules. Now, all three of these methods are valid ways of looking at them. Each have their advantages and their disadvantage. I think using the rules is going to be the fastest, the most efficient once you understand it. But it may be the hardest to understand because there's just more things that you have to remember with it. But we're going to go through all three of them and then kind of compare and contrast and see which one that you like the best and use and go from there. Okay, some things with using a number line that you have to understand. Moves that are positive are to the right of zero. Numbers to the right of zero are positive. Moves or numbers to the left of zero are the negatives. Okay, so that's important. Positives go to the right, negatives go to the left on the number line. Okay, when we get to zero pairs, it's important for us to understand that this pair, negative one and a positive one, together those things are zero. If you gain a yard in football and then you lose a yard, the total of that is zero. You're back to where you started. If you gain a dollar and then you lose a dollar, your net total is zero. So whenever we have this pair, positive and a negative pair, those two things will cancel each other out to give us a zero. A negative and a positive pair will cancel each other out to give us a zero. So that's a little bit of background going into the problems. So using a number line, if we have the problem negative 5 plus 3, to use the number line, we always start off at 0. And my first move is going to be the first number that I have in my problem, negative 5. So I start at 0, and I go down to negative 5, which I actually don't have on my number line here, negative 5. So that's my first move. From negative 5, my next move is a positive 3. So I move positive 3 to the right. Because remember, negative moves are to the left, positive moves are to the right. So I move negative 5, and then positive 3, and I'm done. My final answer is right here at positive 2. So negative 5 plus 3 is equal to 2. Similarly, if we have 3 plus negative 6, I start off at 0, and my first move is to positive 3, because positive numbers are to the right. And then my next move is a negative 6, so I've got to move 6 numbers to the left, so I move 3, 4, 5, 6 to the left. And I just count that out, going to the left. And notice that I always start at 0, and then my next move is from wherever my arrow stopped at. So I move to positive 3, so and then my next move is from positive 3, I move to my next thing, which is negative 6, so I move 6 to the left, and my final answer is here at negative 3. So 3 plus negative 6 equals negative 3. So this is just a model that we have. It's a model for working with adding and subtracting, just adding integers. Now this is another model that we have of using zero pairs. And what we talked about with zero pairs is that anytime we have a positive and negative pair, that together gives us a zero. Okay? And that's going to be important. So if we have negative 5 plus 3, when we have our pairs, I'm going to write out 5 negatives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we have plus 3, so that's 3 positives. 1, 2, 3 positives. Every time we have a zero pair, those cancel out to give us zero. So we have a negative and a positive that cancel to give us zero. Another negative and positive that cancel to give us zero. And finally, another negative and positive that cancel to give us zero. Our final answer is right there, negative 2, which we showed on the number line. Negative 5 plus 3 equals positive 2. Sorry, I wrote that down wrong up here, didn't I? That should have been a negative 2. My fault. Using our next example, we have 3 plus negative 6. And using my zero pairs model, we have positive 3. So I'll write my positive 3 and negative 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And cancel out my zero pairs. Positive and negative cancel. Positive, negative, cancel. Positive and negative cancel. I'm left with 3 negatives. So 3 plus negative 6 equals negative 3. Now, you might want to think about what happens if we add two negatives, like negative 2 plus negative 4. If we look on a number line, start off at 0, and our first move would go from 0 to negative 2. And then I add another negative 4. Negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6. So my next move is going to go 4 more in the negative direction. Final answer is negative 6. Using the number line. Using the zero pairs, we are going to look at negative 2 is 2 negatives. 4 is 4 negatives. There's no zero pair to cancel, so we just count up our negatives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So as we showed with the number line, we have negative 6 as an answer for that. So I've gone through using a number line. I've gone through using zero pairs. I am going to stop this video now and come back to using rules in another video.